Well, Marilyn's gifts are many and wonderful, and she is very generous in the way she has deployed them here. She is a preacher of really consummate skill. I deeply appreciate the work she does and puts into the sermons she writes and her presentation. The sermons are thoughtful, probing, well-crafted. There is a saying attributed to the theologian Karl Barth that when we preach or even approach scripture, we should do so with Bible in one hand and newspaper in the other. Marilyn does it with the Bible in one hand, a newspaper, and an anthology of poetry, because she draws on her love of poetry, a love of literature, and that infuses and really brings alive her sermons. I have seen her in that leadership position, especially during our interim time. That was a time when there was a lot that was expected of her, and she exercised leadership with grace, with real skill and insight, and I am especially grateful, as we all here are, for her extraordinary leadership during that time. Marilyn has been a wonderful pastor that is engaged in pastoral work. I can say from my own experience, having gone through the death of my wife, her sustaining efforts on our behalf were, they were skillful, they were graceful, she was sensitive. She knew when it was time to tell a joke or to hear a joke. She knew when it was time to feel sad. She then, with Phyllis Court, put together a funeral service for Linda, which so connected with who Linda was and who I was at the time and how we lived our life within this Reformed tradition. She was really thoughtful and understanding. And for that, I myself will be always grateful for her efforts.
Marilyn has been like a sister to me. I don't have much family, and none in the area. And from early on, Marilyn was at my side through thick and thin. You know, I spent some times in hospitals, and she was there at my side and never judged me, was always supportive. When my father passed away, Marilyn did the service, and my father was not an easy man to like. And Marilyn did a beautiful job of doing the sermon and making him, you know, making it meaningful. And everyone who was there was just really impressed. And it meant the world to me because I really wasn't sure how we were going to do this. But she was with me. She prayed with me right before he died. She was at the bedside with me as he was passing. About a month and a half ago, I had to put my 15-year-old cat to sleep. And, you know, some people understand that. Other people just are like, oh, yeah, so you put your cat to sleep. But Marilyn truly understood how incredibly important my cats were to me. He was 15. And she called me a couple of hours before I had to put him to sleep, just to touch base with me. And it's the constant surrounding. You know, we do things like go to lunch and touch base, and you know, I was in her Bible studies, and she helped coordinate the moving teams when my apartment was flooded by Florence. You know, just always approachable, always caring. She was just always there. If I was upset or sad, you know, I always knew that I could talk to Marilyn.
Marilyn was always creative. We had to come up with themes for things like the Sunday school kickoff, and she would always come up with something creative, but we could always easily put Bible verses or things from theology into the theme. The best way that she has done that for me is when my husband Tom died and she did his funeral. She connected the dots really well. She came and was asking us, you know, tell me some stuff about Tom and things that we wouldn't necessarily know. And I said, he loved to feed babies. He thought it was hilarious and he loved the mess. And just even if it was coming right back out, he would just keep shoveling it in. And she took that and matched it with what she also knew about him professionally, which was that he loved to mentor students. And he would, she connected it as, you know, shoveling in information, and it's kind of messy and some of it comes right back out, and you just keep shoving it in. It meant a lot to me that she connected those dots and helped all of us see that gift that Tom had. My favorite thing about Marilyn is that she has this creative set of lenses, and everything is viewed through that. So she does a lot of play on words. She paints pictures with her words. Her sermons bring in all kinds of things, poetry or music, or even a children's game. Rather than just hearing the scripture the same old way, you see it through new eyes and you hear it with new ears. Share well, share with your brother, share well, my friend. Take the people well, love one another, share well, my friend.
Church a long time together. It's been here before I was born, so we've always been friends. She's always helped me out a lot and helped me grow in the church. One of my favorite memories is one of my relatives gifted me some Jesus Band-Aids over Christmas, and so I came back and told Marilyn about these Jesus Band-Aids that I had, and I gave her one. And then she really liked them, and then she liked them so much she put them in the Easter eggs for the yearly Easter egg hunt that we hold. That's one of my favorite stories, and that teaches us to like always accept new things and be ready to accept them. So change is usually a good thing.
A big, big house with lots and lots of room. A lots and lots of food. A big, big yard where we can play football touchdown. Big, big house. It's my father's house.
I was going to the emergency room because I thought I was having a little heart thing. So I emailed Marilyn saying, I can't come to the meeting because I'm in the ER. And then I was sitting there thinking, oh, I hope she got my email. And then suddenly Marilyn walked into the emergency room and there she was. And so we had a great meeting right there. And of course, obviously I wasn't having a heart event. Well, there are more ways than just her wonderfulness coming to the hospitals. Marilyn's prayers are fantastic. I just love them. So that when Marilyn says, let us pray, I think to myself, oh goody, this is gonna be great. Marilyn's a poet, she's a writer. I don't know if it's that, but I love her prayers. I could listen to them all day long. So that's been a big impact. And what I would like to say is moving forward, I will seek to appreciate prayers of the people and prayers, and I think I'm learning to listen to prayers differently, and I owe that to Marilyn. So that's an impact. Another impact is that she taught me about the kingdom of God, that here we are, we're all in the kingdom of God, and to just have that understanding of the world, and that's invaluable. It's part of her inclusiveness, and all that she's taught us about, so I've watched kids grow up, my own kids grow up in the church, how if you're baptized, well, if you decide that you don't want to be confirmed after going through confirmation, you're still under our umbrella, no matter what. When we take, our baptismal promises when a child is christened, baptized, we will watch over, as a church, watch over that child, whether they join the church or not. And I just love that.
Well, she's a very good preacher, and she's also good when she runs a adult Sunday school class. She's very good.
I would add to that, she has a lot of gifts. She's a very talented person. She's a wonderful preacher, and she's a very caring and compassionate human being, which has made her a wonderful pastor. But I think, for me, her words, she's a wordsmith. She knows how to use words, and it's a real gift to be able to give expression to ideas and to images and to poems. She's a poet. So her many gifts have been really a very much of an enriching part of our life and the life of this congregation. We were fortunate to have her come join us as associate pastor. We needed some help and she jumped right in, and later she became an associate pastor here, and it was really one of the great days for our church. Sometimes God sends you what you need even when you don't know how much you need it, and she was certainly that kind of gift for us. It's been a wonderful opportunity to get to know Marilyn Ann Hedge and her children and to watch them as a family. They are a very dedicated family and then to watch her become a grandparent, oh my gosh, she was over the top as a grandmother, and she's still really enjoying that a lot. So my hope and prayer is that she's going to have a rich and enjoyable retirement as she moves on into the next phase of her life.
Thank you.